Guys, welcome back to my channel, and it's me again, your G. So for today's video, guys, remember the last vlog about life updates and good news to newcomers that I share with you? I have to give you an update on that, especially the assistance to newcomers upon arrival here in Canada that was made possible by the FCNB or the Filipino Community of New Brunswick in partnership with the Canadian Red Cross and Employment and Social Development of Canada, in which some of our international students took advantage of this program. The great thing about it is that the program was extended from February 19 to May 21st, 2021. That's a good news, right? So to those arriving international students and its family, from this day forward to May 21st, 2021, please reach out and contact fcnb.crc@gmail.com and provide your information about your quarantine plan and your arrival date. In addition to that, FCNB just recently launched a new program intended to assist temporary workers arriving here in New Brunswick, Canada. This program is partnered with Kairos Canada and IRCC, or Immigration Refugees and Citizenship Canada. And for more details and to keep more updated, I strongly suggest and recommend as well to visit and follow FCNB or Filipino Community of New Brunswick Facebook page. Now, about the EI or the Employment Insurance, guys, I remember I have mentioned as well in my previous vlog, I am happy to tell you that I was approved and right now receiving a benefit and continue reporting my job status as well, and I will give further details about it on my next vlog. So Algonquin now is back in business and I was able to get hours so far, meaning I'm back at work. So it was recently starting last week from the end of February to the first week of March when it gets busy in the hotel. And they call it March break or spring break to the other countries like the US. So here in Canada, provinces give 1 to 2 week long break to their elementary and secondary school students in March, with a time varying from province to province like New Brunswick and Quebec place their March break on the first week of March. Ontario, Nova Scotia and British Columbia scheduling theirs during the second week or third week of March, while the break in Alberta and Manitoba usually occurs in the last week of March. In terms of studies, we are still invented delivery, where we come to school for our courses like accounting and wines and spirits, and the rest of the other courses like menu planning and business law are delivered online. And we still have that big project going for Minister's Island, so I feel like we have so much on the plate. Just kidding. We will finish and complete it, of course, guys. And what stresses me out this past few weeks, guys, is about our passport renewal. Yes, because we are soon to be graduating and we need to renew first our passport before we get to apply for our PGWP or post-graduation work permit. So me and other of my colleagues that I'm currently living with, we are supposed to renew our passport last year, but due to pandemic, it gets cancelled and halted. There are so many situations that happened last year that we are unable to renew our passport, although we are still hoping for the embassy to continue their outreach consular mission here in New Brunswick. But I guess the most easiest and expensive way as well is to book an appointment in the embassy of the Philippines in Ottawa, travel to Ottawa, visit the embassy for passport renewal, and come back here in New Brunswick for self-isolation. That's going to be costly, right? But we don't have a choice but to do that because we badly need to renew our passport. So, to all incoming or future international students, make sure that you have enough validity of your passport to cover the length of your post-graduation work permit. For sure, you all know that post-graduation work permit may be issued based on the length of your study program for a minimum of 8 months up to a maximum of 3 years. But the validity period of post-graduation work permit may not go beyond the applicant's passport validity date. Do you get my point, guys? So for example, if I have my passport expiring next year, February, and I choose to apply for PGWP, then I will get the validity of PGWP valid the same as my passport validity. In this case, I am allowed to extend my PGWP because I didn't get the full length of my permit due to I need to renew my passport first. That is what I'm trying to avoid happening because it's hassle to renew PGWP and making the problem or issue on hold or resolved later when you can solve or complete it right away. So that is the only exception for extending or renewing the PGWP. But PGWP is a one-time opportunity for international students only. And I will put the link in my description below about this. I think I have talked too much, isn't it? But I do hope that this vlog update helps you as well. Oh, before I forgot, I want to thank the Brunswick Multicultural Council for this recognition. You can see it, right? Yeah. Well, thank you so much, guys. Even though my last name is incorrect, or was it spelled wrong, still, I appreciate it. Thank you so much. So that's it. Thank you so much for watching and for staying with me today. So don't forget to hit like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you on my next vlog, guys. Thank you so much. With much love.